if you want to, you know, become a billionaire, help a billion people.
Peter Diamandis, you're renowned as one of the world's great futurists, and you're the co-author of a new book called The Future is Faster Than You Think with Stephen Kotler. Everyone is familiar, I think, with a lot of the theses behind your thinking, but I think people are not quite so focused on another aspect of change that you bring forward in your book, which is the change wrought by migration. Hmm. Throughout human history, migration has been a catalyst for innovation. And you see a number of migrations that will happen in the 21st century that will also be forces for change and also disruption.
We're going to see migrations of the human species out into space. We're going to see continued migration from the rural areas into downtown megacities. We're going to see migration into the virtual world as we start to spend more and more time in a world which is very feature-rich, driven by higher and higher resolution, easier to use virtual reality. We're going to see climate migrations as, you know, sea levels rise. We're going to start to displace people into different areas. And a lot of, there's some negative connotations obviously with that, but that will continue to drive innovation. And then one of the most interesting of these five migrations is what I call the migration to the meta-intelligence. One of the technologies we speak about that people don't really understand how far we've come is connecting the brain to the cloud, our neocortex, the 100 billion neurons, 100 trillion synaptic connections in our brain. We are about on the verge of connecting to the cloud. How do we connect your brain, your sensory and motor cortex of your brain to the cloud, so that when you think, you can Google? And a lot of these transitions are occurring, and they're gonna simply increase the speed that the world is changing and that we're driving innovation.
Another one of the great migrations, which people don't focus on so much, is space migration. Right now it seems like science fiction, but as your book says, it's coming faster than you think.
Yeah, so in The Future is Faster Than You Think, I write about the space migration. I'm a child of the 60s, Apollo and Star Trek drove me. And the pace of space has been really driven by government budgets. It's just now that we're seeing this incredible race between Elon Musk on SpaceX and Jeff Bezos in Blue Origin, where both have the capital and have the intelligence and team to build a new generation of rockets and capabilities that are orders of magnitude cheaper than it was the space shuttle or the Apollo program. And so I have every confidence that in the next decade, we are going to have private companies on the moon. We are going to have private companies, if not on Mars, on the verge of landing on Mars. And all of a sudden, you know, everything we hold of value on Earth, metals, minerals, energy, real estate, is in infinite quantities in space. You know, I write about this and talk about this, that the next trillionaires will be made in space. We are the equivalent of the early explorers of the 14 and 1500s looking out to the new world. It's right now. Whatever we evolve to as a human species, you know, hundreds or thousands of years from now, we're going to look back at these next two decades as the moment in time that we move off the planet irreversibly. It's a beautiful time. And as we do that, we're going to have to think about what laws do we take with us? What cultural norms do we take with us? Are we going to reboot new governance systems as we go into space? It's a tremendous period, and that migration is going to drive very rapid innovation and evolution.